Case 3 dot for lung nodules. Single view chest radiograph demonstrates a tracheostomy in satisfactory position. The enteric tube terminates in the stomach. The side hole is below the gastroesophageal junction. The left port catheter terminates in the right atrium. The right PICC terminates in the distal SVC. Mild cardiomegaly, atherosclerotic thoracic aorta. There are rounded densities projecting over both hemithoraces, also over the lung fields and into the surrounding soft tissues. The underlying lungs are clear. There is no pleural effusion. There is no pneumothorax. The ASVI structures are unremarkable. Concomitant CT scan of the chest demonstrates that the rounded opacities were indeed calcifications within the chest wall and not within the lungs. This patient underwent silicone injection into both of her breasts, and these tiny individual injections eventually calcified. So as you could see in a chest radiograph, the calcific opacities did not project only over the lungs, but also over the surrounding soft tissues, which was very important finding to make to differentiate calcified granulomas in lungs versus calcifications within the chest wall. Notably on the chest CT scan, she has bilateral pleural effusions and also by basilar compressive atelectasis. To view chest radiograph demonstrates a pulmonary nodule in the right lower lobe, which you can see both on the AP view and also on the lateral view. This nodule is very easily visible and appears denser than the surrounding osseous structures, which suggests that this is indeed a granuloma. Otherwise, the lungs are clear, normal cardiomediastinal contour, there is no pleural effusion, no pneumothorax, the osseous structures are remarkable. A CT of the chest in the same patient demonstrates the calcified nodule in the right lower lobe. And you can see this both on the soft tissue window and on the lung window. And it has very similar density to the ribs, so this is calcified consistent with the granuloma. One more case of granulomatous disease. This patient has multiple calcified nodules throughout both lungs. There are also calcified mediastinal and hilar lymph nodes, which are best seen perhaps on the lateral view. Single view chest radiograph demonstrates mass lack airspace consolidation in the left suprahilar region, that is elevation of the left hilum, suggesting atelectasis in the left upper lobe. There is also widening of the upper mediastinum, which suggests mediastinal lymphadenopathy. There's also some right hilar fullness, which can be seen in hilar adenopathy as well. CT scan of the chest in the same patient shows the left upper lobe mass and the atelectasis behind the mass. There is both mediastinal and hilar lymphadenopathy on both sides. So this is a left upper lobe mass with mediastinal and hilar nodal metastases. Single view of the chest demonstrates normal cardiomediastinal contour. There is mild atherosclerotic disease of the thoracic aorta. There's a faintly visualized nodular opacity in the right mid-lung zone, otherwise the lungs are clear. There is no pleural effusion and there is no pneumothorax. Here is a magnified image of the nodule. So this is very faintly visualized. It's not quite the density of the adjacent osseous structures. Therefore, a CT scan of the chest was recommended for further evaluation. CT of the chest on lung windows demonstrates a pulmonary nodule in the right upper lobe with adjacent small satellite nodules. On the soft tissue window, it's obvious that the lesion has central calcification, therefore it is consistent with the granuloma. To view chest radiograph demonstrates cardiomegaly, atherosclerotic thoracic aorta, and diffuse interstitial thickening consistent with interstitial edema. This picture is consistent with CHF. The patient also has a nodular opacity in the right middle lobe. On the lateral view that you can see that indeed this nodule projects over the expected region, the right middle lobe, the CHF and right middle lobe pulmonary nodule. Single view of the chest demonstrates a mass lack consolidation in the right lower lobe. There is also fullness of the right hilum suggesting right hilar lymphadenopathy. No more heart size, the left lung is clear, there is no pleural effusion and no pneumothorax, and no destructive osseous lesion is visualized. A CT scan on the same patient demonstrates the right lower lobe mass, which abuts the pleura and the diaphragmatic surface, and there is associated metastatic right hilar lymphadenopathy.